स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द वर्कशीट ऑफ द रेशो एंड एज आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट यू पीपल हैव थॉरली रिवाइज द टॉपिक रेशो, सो इट इज़ क्वाइट ईजी फॉर यू टू सॉल्व दिस वर्कशीट इफ यू पीपल रिवाइज द टॉपिक ऑफ रेशो थॉरली फ्रॉम योर बुक्स इन द वर्कबुक. सो कम ऑन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज़ द फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. रेशो इज़ अ कंपेरिजन बिटवीन द क्वान्टिटीज ऑफ डैश काइंड. Since we are taking the comparison of the ratio between the shapes or between the animals or between the mass, volume, or we can say that between the different kind of fruits. So it means that we are always taking the comparison of the same kind of quantities. If we are talking about the mass, we are taking the comparison between the masses. If we are talking about the fruits, we are taking the comparison of the fruits. And if we are talking about the shapes, different shapes, so we are talking about the same thing, that is a shape. So ratio is a comparison between the quantities of the same kind. Second one, if two ratios are equal, then they are dash ratios. When the two ratios are equal, say 1 over 2, 1 ratio 2 is equals to 2 ratio 4. So if you simplify 2 ratio 4, it means it will give you the same answer 1 ratio 2. So when the two ratios are equal, then they are equivalent ratios. The third one is the ratio of 5 paisas to 25 paisas is same as ratio of 20 paisas to dash paisas. Now we are taking 5 to 20. It means we are making 520. How? By multiplying 5 with 4. Similarly, we have to multiply 25 with 4. It will give you the answer of 100 paisas. Fourth one, a ratio expressed in the lowest form has dash common factor. When the ratio is written in its simplified form, it means it has now no common factor except one. Okay, because it cannot be further simplified. So this is a ratio expressed in the lowest form has no common factor. The ratio 4 ratio 16 in its simplest form. Simplest form is that form of the ratio which cannot be further divided by any common factor. So 1 ratio 16 when written in the simplest form is equals to 1 ratio 4. Coming to the question number 2. In a managed forest, the different trees are planted and the trees are apple, orange and maple trees. For every apple tree, there must be 2 orange trees and 5 maple trees are planted. Write down the ratio of trees planted. So here we are making the comparison of the same thing, that is a trees, and there are the trees of the different kinds. Apple, orange and maple, and the ratio is given that for every apple tree means for every one apple tree there must be 2 orange tree and 5 maple tree. So we can write the ratio in this form. In the second part, if 6 orange trees are planted, then how many apple trees would be planted? Since the ratio of apple to orange tree is already given in part 1 as 1 ratio 2, so we are taking 2 to 6. It means we are multiplying 2 with 3 to make it 6. Similarly, we have to multiply 1 with 3 to give you the answer 3. So 3 apple trees would be planted. In the third part, if 40 maple trees are planted, then how many orange trees would be planted? So coming to the part 1, where the orange to maple tree ratio is given as 2 ratio 5, since there would be 40 maple trees, and 5 times 8 is equals to 40. So we multiply the 2 with the same common factor, that is 8, which will give you the answer 16. So 16 orange trees would be planted. In part 4, due to rise in demand of apple, the ratio of trees planted changes to apple ratio orange ratio maple is 3 ratio 2 ratio 5. It means that for every 3 apple trees, there must be 2 orange trees and 5 maple trees. Now, if 36 apple trees were planted, then how many maple trees would be planted? Now, the ratio of apple trees changes from 1 to 3. So if there will be 36 apple trees, so 3 times 12 is equals to 36. So here the common factor is 12. So multiply 5 with 12, it will give you the answer 60. So when 36 apple trees are planted, then 60 maple trees will be planted. Question number 3, reduced ratio to its simplest form. The first one is 48:36. If I divide 48 and 36 with 12, it will give you the answer, since 12 fourths are 48 and 12 threes are 36. So the ratio in the simplest form is 4:3. The second part is 120:110:100. So I can simplify it by dividing it with 10, because this is the easiest way. If every number in a ratio ends with 0, so it's easy to divide it first by 10. This will give you the ratio 12:11:10. Come to the question number 4. Write the equivalent ratio in each of the following. Since 3:4:5, here the first hint is given as 12. So 3 fourths are 12. So here the common factor is 4. So multiply 4 with 4, this will give you 16. And multiply 4 with 5, this will give you 20. In the second part, 18:12:30. Here the hint given is that 12 is reduced to 6. So if 12 is reduced to 6, it means the common factor that dividing the 12 is 6 is 2. So if we divide 18 with 2, this will give you the answer 9, and 30 with 2, this will give you the answer 15. In question number 5, the ratio of goats to cow in the farm is 4:6. If there are 48 cows in the farm, how many total animals are there in the farm? So now he is asking about the total animal. For the total animal, we first know how many goats are there. So first of all, from the ratio, we have to find for the 48 cows, how many goats are present in the farm. Since 6 eights are 48, so here the common factor is 8. So 4 eights are 32. So there must be 32 goats in the farm if 48 cows are present. So the total animal now is obtained by adding the total number of goats plus total number of cows. So 32 plus 48 is equals to 80.